The eyeball transition effect is one of the coolest effects out there. And if you want to learn how to do this in Filmora 9, stick around. I'll show you how. Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation. The first thing you want to do is find a couple pieces of footage that you can use. In this case, I'm just going to use two images that I found off pixabay.com, and I'll bring those down into my timeline. Let me stretch this image out a little bit. I'm going to right-click on that and hit crop to fit. That will make sure it fills up the entire preview window and the entire screen 16:9 on export. The next image I'll bring down is the image of this cat and put it right behind it. I'll stretch that out a bit too. If I right click on this footage and hit crop to fit, it'll do the same thing and fill that window. What I'm going to do is isolate a section of this footage here and slice it, and then do the same with that cat image. Now in the first image, I'm going to right click on it and open up crop and zoom. And you can see it's already cropped down to fit the screen. That's what the crop to fit feature did. But if we click on pan and zoom, you'll see it opens up our zoom window. What we want to do is click inside of the end screen to activate it. And then let's grab the corner of this and shrink it down. We want to keep this at a 16:9 ratio, so let's make sure we click on the 16:9 in the dropdown so that it doesn't distort and create any black lines in our final export. I'm going to put that right over her left eye. So what the instructions I'm giving Filmora to do with this clip is to start with this full screen and zoom on in down towards her eye to this size. Let's hit OK. So what we have happening so far is this first image we have sitting full screen, and where I sliced it, I gave it the instructions to start zooming in towards her eye. Now let's move over to this cat footage. Let's take the small section I sliced and right click on that. Let's hit crop and zoom, and we're going to do a very similar thing. We're going to use the pan and zoom feature. We'll click inside of the end, but I actually want this to start in on the cat's eye. So down in the lower right, let's use these reverse arrows, and that will turn the end window into the start window and the start window into the end window. The way you can tell, if you look at the lower left corner of each, they actually say end and start. Can you see those? And when I click this, it says swap the start and end areas. So each time we click it, it swaps them back and forth. We'll take this new start and bring it all the way down to a small square, but we still want that to only be 16:9, which is the standard aspect ratio that YouTube uses where I'm going to be hosting this video. So let's shrink that down really small. Let's bring that right up to the cat's eye here. Just make sure that the smaller image is the start image. So we're starting from the inside of the cat's eye and working our way back out. So now the inside is set as the start, and click OK. So now what we've done is we've started with this full screen image of this woman. We've zoomed in towards her eye, and when we get to the cat, it swaps right over and comes back out. So it almost looks like she turned into a cat. One thing we can do in here is if we go up to the transition area, let's look up our dissolve transition, and let's bring that down right where these two pieces of footage meet. I'm going to stretch out my footage so I can see this a little better. We don't need this dissolve to be very long. I just want it to slightly blend from her eye into the cat's eye. So let's take a look. And that's a nice swap, really fast. Let's shrink it down and let's see how that plays. Always use your eye to figure out what you think the effect needs or doesn't need. We've got the zoom in. That's a little too much. I feel like that's too much. I want that to be faster. Let me shrink that a little bit. It zooms in, bam, comes back out. That's a little bit better. I also think this overall effect could be a little bit quicker, so I'm gonna grab this section and shorten it up, and grab the cat section and shorten it up a little bit, and then I'm gonna left click on the first one, hold the shift key, and click on the last piece of footage, and move them all to the left. Until they all connect. Now they're all together. Let's take a look and see what that looks like. I like the way that looks. That's a little bit smoother. Keep in mind, you could do this with video of yourself actually moving. Zoom into your eyeball in one location and zoom back out from another piece of footage and make it look like you totally changed locations. If you want to learn how to do more cool effects with Filmora, click on these videos over here to get you on your way.